gabi sa inyong tanan. Ngayong gabi, wow, may Bisaya na sulti na. Sa speech na ako, English. So, basahin na ako kung hindi nyo kasabot, ako translate, okay? Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am very pleased to welcome you tonight and I wish to thank for your coming. Talagang, I'm very touched, and this is speaking. I'm touched with the effort of those who came all the way from Tenerife, Las Palmas, Palmas de Mallorca, Malaga, Barcelona, Soto Grande, Fuengirola, Mallorca, Andorra, of course, yung mga malaki dito Madrid. We apologize that we cannot use the garden, sayang yung garden in the dark. Lilinis ko kahapon. Pero malas tayo. Hindi kayo nagdasal masyado. On my residence because of the rain forecast, but it is indeed a pleasure to personally meet all of you tonight, and I hope that this is the start of more collaboration efforts between the embassy and your organization. Alam niyo, parang bata ako, pero I've been serving the government over 20 years now.
Wow,
bata pa ko.
Yes, sir.
I've served the Philippines as ambassador for the past 20 years. Sa Argentina only for 45 days. Italy, San Marino for 11 years.
Wow.
Portugal for 4.5 years. And now, nandito ako sa Spain.
Thank you. Forever.
Alam mo, tumatanda tayo.
My forever, sir.
Meron ba kayong tableta ng in my years as ambassador, the Philippine community has always been an important part of my leadership. I really find that, alam niyo, pinangkap ko itong trabaho because I really enjoy very much the community. Okay, that's my first love, second love, and third love.
Thank you, sir.
Swerte yung masama ko, hindi nag-credit ko. I believe that the Philippine community organizations are the embassy's partners in pursuing its objectives. However, our objectives can only be achieved if we join our hands together. I wish to call on each one of you to work together as one. Walang away, please. One team, basketball team. One family, one nation, and one big organization. With this in mind, I wish to thank for your support to 2019 para sa sampung pinakamatagal na hindi pinakamatandahan matagal na magagawa Pilipino dito sa Espanya at Andorra. I also wish to encourage everyone to support the 2019 national election, pero hindi ako tumatakbo, ha? Okay. Which will start on April 13, 2019 until May 13, 2019. I also hope to see you in the forthcoming Filipino Community Independence Ball on the 9th of June, 2019. Also for the organizations outside Madrid, thank you for your continued assistance during our consular outreach service. Kung wala kayo doon magtutulong, wala kaming visa, papasok. To all of you who never fail to share information and updates from the embassy, your assistance has been very valuable and we appreciate it very much. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Last month, the embassy launched in Palma de Mallorca the Information Handbook for Filipinos. I hope that it's not going mahal yung printing press. Tonight, we also be distributing the information handbooks which contains useful information for Filipinos. Tonight, the embassy is officially launching yet another project for the Filipino community. In cooperation with our dear organizations, tawag namin ito ay Project Lifeline. Direktang linya sa embahada.
Wow.
Maraming yes, kung sa mga ganyan. Kung ano pa sa sabihin natin, wireless, ano? Loveless. More love. But anyway, alam mo, itong project nito, this has been planned more than 1 year ago. And inaralan namin na it will be a perfect plan and a perfect project. Alam niyo kayo, my organization, meron kayo, pero you have some plans, some fail, some don't fail. And I don't want to come to fail. So, when I was in Italy, marami ako project na kawa doon. And thank God that we've been successful. And I hope dito sa Spanya, we shall be also successful. Like I say, this can't be successful by the embassy alone. Kailangan kayo na. But if kayo dumating ngayon araw, I believe it will be very, very successful. This is one of a kind project which I am proud of. The purpose of this, alam mo nitong purpose itong project, because Directa Lineas sa Embajada is for all embassy accredited organizations to have an accessible direct line to the embassy. Para yung ring ring, Philippine Embassy, diretso kayo dito. There will be 3 direct lines which will be made available for all of you. You can text or call on these lines whenever you need information or assistance. You can now attend more assistance to your members and other kababayans by using these direct lines. I want all of you to have a direct access to the embassy. That's my purpose of my life here. At least kung hindi naman mga sad stories, happy stories, amba, may party ako dito sa bahay ko, invitein ko naman ako, pupunta ako. Okay? Right? And tawag natin, Project Lifeline, which also means help or assistance, is composed of several stages. Directa Lineas sa Embajada is the first stage, which is aimed at providing you easy access to the embassy. Alam niyo, sabi ito, tawag kayo sa embassy. Ring! Pagsagot. Upos na yung load ko. So ngayon, wala na. Isang ring. Hello? Philippine Embassy. Which is aimed at providing you easy access to the embassy. I hope you use these connections well and use it to help as many Filipinos as possible. So, okay, mahaba na yung speech ko. The embassy will give you 3 direct lines or numbers that you can always call or text. Okay ba yan?
Yes!
Akin na ibigay niyo yung akin? Akin na, kasama rin ako, okay? Para, ring ring, hello, embassy, okay.
Wala na problema.
Wala na. Sa telepono, masusolve na natin yung problema. Okay. But the question is, how is it different from the already existing telephone numbers of the embassy that you already have? The answer is, first, these 3 numbers are dedicated to you. Second, this is also our direct line to you. Aha, hindi lang papunta sa akin. Sa inyo rin. Tatawag kami sa inyo. Hello?
Hello.
Okay ba? Third. Tararang!
Surprise.
Third, I will give you mobile phones that you can use.
Wow. Magic!
Alam ninyo,
of course. Magic.
Itong mga telepono ito imported from the Philippines. Not only that, this is the first base we have, and I have right now another company that nag-invest ako sa telepono will improve the sources. But the most important thing, by the way, is this phone, first to lifeline. But the second phase, very, very soon, nagpagawa ako na isang application na ilalagay natin sa phone dyan. Na anything you want to know about embassy, about Spain, about anywhere. Anyway, all these details, si Chester will explain to you. Ano pa ba mga project namin? Ginagawa na namin, by the way. By the way, pagkatapos ito, before the matapos ng meeting, I'll be also asking each one of you to give us anong gusto ninyo ipapasok. Hindi naman yung telephone number ninyo na or mga retrato ninyo, wag naman, no? let us work together because I think this is the first time ever in any embassy in the world. Yes. That has such a thing.
Yay!
So I will turn over the mic to our AO Chester, who has been working hard for all of this. And I really hope that itong lifeline will be helpful. And I really hope that you will make use of it, please. At maybe after this, meron tayo ibang mga gusto maging membro. My cellphone, bukas ako. Pero at least itong mga association natin ngayon really has passed to the committee. Very strict committee. You have to be 15 and all those things. Okay, and we could have other projects. Like Sina said, because in my first year that I was here, to be exact, it will be 2 years that will be to next month. That's yung dream ko pa is really to have a Philippine Center. That's really my dream. To say, kung I said that tayo, rain or shine nasa loob tayo, kasa tayo. Yes. Like kanina, we had a very successful meeting with mga franchising. Okay, probably. Meron tayong dalawang important galing sa Pilipinas na nag-explain what is franchising. But the thing that made me really interesting, maraming pumunta. At pagkatapos, meron kami questions and answers at monitoring. At meron isang grupo. Meron pa isang Espanyol na walang connection sa Pilipinas, sabi niya sa akin. Ambassador, in Espanyol. Pero sabi niya sa akin, Ambassador, how do I know Filipino products? Wala akong nakikita. You should have a place, a permanent showroom. Na ganun, sabi ko, that's really my plan. Pero alam ninyo, sometimes in life we make plans, but I hope and pray that we shall be successful here. I was giving up already mga 3 weeks ago, sabi ko, ang hirap ito. I've been talking to the Spanish government, I've been talking to the Philippine government, wala talaga support dito. Because, alam mo, iba yung isip nila, hindi sila nag-isip lang for the betterment of everybody. Hmm. Itong center ito will really make us one. Rather than people. And we shall show the host country what the Philippines is today. Hindi tayo 1898. Yes. Marami sa kanila hindi alam na how the Philippines is, what we are, and what we are helping Spain. And these are many projects, pero rin ako isang project na hindi ko lang sasabihin ngayon na hopefully that it will come true. We are working out with the Spanish government on everything. And again, I would want to, this will be the last thing I'm going to say, is that yung project ko na Balik Filipino, I hope mga kababayan ninyo, mga kapag-anak ninyo, lahat-lahat, just kanina, meron isang Espanyol, meron to yung Filipina. Sabi ng Espanyol, I want to do business in the Philippines and I want to own land. Katabi niya yung asawa niya. Sabi yung taga-franchising, about yung asawa mo? She's Spanish in Filipina. Said, we are going to have a project, by the way, mayroon pa kaming gagawin na parang video. Kung gusto kayong maging star dito, madali. Mag-apply lang kayo. Libre lang bayad, ha? Walang bayad, ha? So, we are hoping to have a video. Pakikita sa inyo na madali maging makuha ng jewel ngayon, okay? So, okay. Mayroon ang sabi sa akin, Sir, pwede ba maging libre? We will see what will happen, but I believe that we should really do this project, really. Give an example, the election registration. Alam niyo, Spain, ilan na ito? 28,000 na registered. Compared to last time?
19,000.
11,000 last time. Okay. So imagine, tayo yung pinakamalaking grupo na nag-registro. So it was not trabaho ninyo that you were able to do some campaigns around we have this, okay? So like I say again, thank you very much na dumating kayo ngayong araw. Kasi nag-usap tayo, wala lang ulan. So, but anyway, thank you so much for coming over. And for those people na galing sa malayo, thank you for coming. Yung malapit, thank you also for coming. Tayo lahat, we deserve really taking ourselves, really. Like sinasabi ko, as a businessman, as life, we have to have friends. We have to be together. Alam ninyo, to have an enemy, madali. But it's difficult to really have friends. I have been 20 years in government, and these are the happiest life days of my life. I'm a businessman, alam ninyo.
Yes.
Alam ninyo, meron akong advertiser. Sa Buwan ng Lugier. But if you really, kayo mga pumunta sa seminar kanina, how I started from scratch. It's all hard work. Nagigisa pa umaga, think of ideas, what to do, and all those things. Ngayon, I have 3,200 branches, I have 11,000 employees. Pero, nandito po kasama ako sa inyo lahat. That is one of my happiness, okay?
Yes.
So, let us work together and help one another and try to get more members association natin. Huwag kayo maging masyado strict, okay? And bibigyan ko kayo ng yung diploma namin, yung theory part of the association. And please, I believe, kung meron kayong mga ideas na dapat gagawin ng embassy, gagawin ng Pinoy, Philippine Embassy. Ayaw mo sagot. So anyway, I will turn over the mic to Rayo Chester right here, who will explain to you more the details of the project. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ambassador.